अभी मैं राजनीति में नहीं हूं, किसी पार्टी का भी नहीं हूं, और ये संवैधानिक दायित्व के कारण से राजनीति में हस्तक्षेप करना भी नहीं। मेरा जन्मस्थान नेल्लूर जिले आंध्र प्रदेश में, और एक किसान परिवार में मैं पैदा हुआ, और मेरा घर में या मेरे परिवार में उस समय कोई पढ़े लिखे भी नहीं था। मैं 3 किलोमीटर पैदल जाके स्कूल में जाके फिर वापस आते थे, और पढ़ने के लिए शाम को वहाँ बिजली भी नहीं होती थी। और धीरे धीरे वहाँ से जब हाई स्कूल में प्रवेश के लिए मैं नेल्लूर शहर में जिला मुख्यालय वहाँ पहुँचा, तो उस समय एक टर्निंग पॉइंट था मेरे जीवन में। कारण है, बचपन से ग्रामीण बैकग्राउंड होने के कारण से मुझे कबड्डी और खो खो खेलने में बहुत रुचि था, खेलते थे भी। एक दिन किसी ने मुझे कहा, एक अमुक इलाके में लोग शाम को कबड्डी खेलते बहुत बढ़िया खेलते, वहाँ जाके देखे। तो वही ऐसी एक दिन 1963 मेरे ख्याल से 9th क्लास में था, तो गए तो वहाँ लोग एक सैफरन फ्लैग लगा के एक ग्राउंड में कबड्डी खेल रहे थे, और बहुत बढ़िया खेल रहे थे सचमुच में। इट वॉज सो इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इट इज एक्साइटिंग। तो देन आई वॉज जस्ट वॉचिंग द गेम फ्रॉम द रोड। सो वन जेंटलमैन हु इज वेरी शार्प, वेरी स्मार्ट, डायनामिक, ही हैज स्पॉटेड मी एंड देन he asked me, do you want to play? मैंने कहा हाँ। उन्होंने कहा आ जाओ। I said, I am not your member or any, I don't know what it is. I am not a member of your club also. Then he said, don't worry, there is no membership as such. You can come and play. Then I asked him, can I come daily and play? He said, yes, you can come daily and play kabaddi. So I played kabaddi with the others, and it was very interesting experience. Later I found that it was a RSS Shakha branch, and they are all gathering there every day evening for 1 hour. Name was it was Vikram Shakha, one of the areas of the town. So, and the person who called me, his name was Sri Bhogadi Durga Prasad. Bhogadi is surname, Durga Prasad. So dynamic, so impressive. I must tell you, he attracted me like a magnet. And then I developed interest first in him, then later kabaddi, and later then sangha. That has really changed my course of life. Then I started going regularly. After some time I got introduced to ABVP. So people used to jokingly call ABVP mane Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ABVP. So it was a little interesting. because we were hearing the name of Vajpayee ji now and then. उस समय इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया नहीं था, अखबार भी उतना पॉपुलर नहीं था, फिर भी ऑल इंडिया रेडियो वगैरह. सो दैट हैज रियली टॉट मी द सो कॉल्ड लीडरशिप. द बेसिक कैरेक्टर मोल्डिंग फाउंडेशन फॉर माय फ्यूचर रेड डाउन in the RSS branch. But the leadership, organization, movement, mobilization, and then thinking about the society. They used to say, Jnanamu, Sidamu, Ekata. Jnana means knowledge. Sila means character. Ekta means unity. That was the. So, and then by going to RSS, by attending ABVP meetings, I started learning more and more about our culture, our heritage, our forefathers. And then they used to sing very good, very interesting patriotic songs. And then slowly learnt how to be a social human being, then how to live along with others, and then developed a social outlook first, and then national outlook next. And then as an ABVP activist, I went to Calcutta, I went to Guwahati, I went to Indore in 1966, I think, National Conference. Then I went, of course, I came to Delhi in 1970, and then went to Trivandrum for the National Conferences. That has exposed me to the country, to the education system, to the various facets of life. Then I went to RSS regularly. Then I had my first year OTC, then I had my second year OTC, and then moved on. But in spite of all this, I was never into politics. I was slowly developing interest in Vajpayee ji because people used to call him at that time Taruna Hrudaya Samrat. He used to be a great attraction for the youngsters those days because of his poetic speeches. So, as a student, then elections came. So, ABVP wanted me to contest. I contested the election, became the vice president of the college, became the president of the college subsequently, because the president ran away. There was a problem. One Pahilwan, cinema actor also, as a Pahilwan, one day he had a cinema hall. One day he bet one student. So evening the other students came and told me, we're all roaming on the main road because the life is not complete without coming to trunk road. Trunk road is the road in the city. In every city there will be some place like that where all youngsters or even other retired people also, they just go around. So there they told me, you know, our student is beaten in the car, cinema hall. So then immediately I, along with other colleagues, we went to the cinema hall. Their gates were closed. Then we forced our way inside and we asked them. They said, cinema is on, nothing happened here. What are you talking? So then we were moving here and there. Then that gatekeeper told me, sir, the boy who is beaten is dragged inside and he is put in the camera room. So then we mustered courage and went inside. The owner, otherwise is no good man, I am told, but is a file one. So he came out and he started shouting, what are you doing? Why are you coming inside? He said, you bred down one of our students. And then you are not allowing us to see him. He said, nobody is here. Then we started moving to the theater room. Then he tried to push us down. So then we quarreled with him. But because of his body and the appearance and the staff with him, we could not do much. But we came out and then again went around. There used to be private hostels, few government hostels. So we sent boys around the hostels, mobilized more students, and then went to cinema hall again, started throwing thrones from outside, and then forced our way inside. And then finally located the boy. He was a little unconscious. He was beaten. His name was Bangar Reddy. Bangaru means gold, Reddy. He's from Royal Sima region. And little, but the fellow was going, he was standing in a queue for the cinema ticket. And the queue, it was like this, and then that booking counter was that side. So the queue has to take a turn. When he was coming to take a turn, the other people in the queue pushed him. So he came out of the queue. By that time, the owner came from outside. He saw and thought, this boy is bypassing the queue and entering it in between. So he dragged him. This boy, as I told you, is from the Rayalaseema region, which is known as little ferocious. He rewarded and he said, "What? Why are you doing this?" Then the quarrel started and, of course, he was beaten. So then night, we quarreled, we broke the screens and all, number of other things. But at the end of the day, they have driven us out. Yesterday, well, that was late in the night, so next day morning, then we all sat together, consulted others and all. Everybody said, no, we should take revenge, we cannot really take this. So then we mobilized the students from the entire city, all colleges, Polytechnic College, ITI, and then the other schools and all. Mobilized people came back again in big procession and then had a big fight. This man is affiliated to CPM. So they also came in good number. There was a big fight. That day also we could not do much. But the determination was such because of the background, RSS, ABVP, we have decided no, must fight back. So we had a general body meeting, and in general body meeting everybody started saying it's very atrocious, how can we leave it? But at the same time, some people cautioned, after all, he's a big a cinema actor and also a file one. How can we fight with him? Let us give a complaint and then leave it there. But the youngsters, majority of them prevailed, and they said we must continue the strike. This area in which he lives is a little notorious. So the villagers also, they are afraid. So the word went around, parents from the villagers came and started taking up their boy, taking back their boy. He said, no, we have sent you to study. What is this? Let us go back. Like that. Half of the boys have gone. But we mobilized and students formed a joint action committee and directed me as the president or convener, whatever it is. And then the entire district went on strike, thousands of students came, and then finally police has to, the matter was raised in assembly and police has to arrest him. That's the first exposure to a movement. And I remember, because of the Sangha background, that confidence of fighting injustice, and then mobilization of the youth across the district, that all happened. That was again another turning point in my life. Of course, then I told you elections came, and elections, general elections came. Then without knowing what it is, we used to go on campaign, used to write on walls. Then Vajpayee ji came, I used to make an announcement on the Jatka Tanga, those days no taxis, no autos, saying that aaj shaam ko aam sabha hai, Kopat Maidan mein. श्रीमान अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी पधार रहे तो सभा को सफल बनाइए ऐसा अनाउंस करते थे मैं बट आई नेवर न्यू द बॉय हु हैज रिटन ऑन वॉल्स अबाउट द पार्टी एंड मेड एन अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ श्री अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी सारेवल कैन बिकम द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द रूलिंग पार्टी वन डे and sit between same Vajpayee and Advani and then run the party in the country, the BJP, the president. So this is how the basic training that has been given and also the samskara that has been given by the Sangha and the orientation I had from Sangha has really brought me to this. There is an interesting thing that I come from a very strong agriculture background. My grandparents used to have good land. Those days they used to be called as land lots. Whoever has got a little extra land, they used to call. So in the village, one day my father's friend came in a jeep. He wanted my father to accompany him. Both had weakness to fight, to purchase oxen, Ongole bulls, and also sometimes horses. So that man, one man got ready. He sent a vehicle. My father was about to go, but the Anga Vastram was, those days all riders used to wear the Anga Vastram, a cloth here, to protect from rain, to protect from hot sun, and also to erase the sweat, etc. That was a multi-purpose. Grandfather used to tell me, this is multi-purpose. So then immediately my mother sent word to Dobi. Those days, Dobi used to wash clothes every day, express them and bring them in the evening. So then there is no response. Then second servant was sent, third servant was sent. Then my mother, from the house, she went to the cattle shed. From the cattle shed, she started calling. The other fellow did not come. Then there was a small door. She went again to the second cattle shed and then started calling the... Then while going, there was a buffalo. The buffalo tried to push her. My mother brushed it aside and then went. While coming back, the buffalo hit her. So it hurt. The horns from this side has come to the other side. I'm told she was carrying me in her, this thing. And she dropped me, 1 year, 3 months old. She died. My father lost balance, went away somewhere. So the family was so disturbed. And there was no guidance whatsoever afterwards. Much of the property also is gone. Relatives and all in the village. People have taken it, and my father also, whoever gives him 500 rupees, he used to write a pronote or a document, 1 acre for this man, 2 acres for that, and like that, the family broke. But afterwards, when my grandfather's parents took care of me, and then my grandparents told me, father, mother wanted you to become a lawyer, advocate, those days. So, that was strong in my mind. I wanted to complete a degree, then go to Benares Hindu University or Nagpur to do post-graduation and also law. I'm told at that time there was provision that you can do 2 courses simultaneously, MA, LLB. We had a Mukhya Shikshak, one Sundar SM. He studied MA, LLB in Nagpur and came to Nellore to study BED. BED is a teacher's this thing. So he used to tell us about Nagpur, about Benares Hindu University, etc. So then I developed an aptitude to go and study. But because of my father, suddenly my father suddenly appeared again, and after some time he became sick. So the entire relatives started pressurizing me, saying that you first get married and let someone take care of your father. Why I'm telling you is you will understand how great is Sangha. So I was not that much inclined to my father, frankly, because I used to hear in the village all property was shattered away, father disappeared, did not bother about the family or young kids, etc. So I was keen to go and study and then move on. But all relatives, they forced me like anything. I could not bear the force So one day I told them, okay, I'm going to Nellur. I will ask Sangha Pracharaks and then come back. So the villagers said, Sangha Pracharaks, already these fellows are sannyasis. Sangha Pracharak means bachelors. So what the advice they are going to give? I said, let me. I went to Vibhag Pracharak, this gentleman, Durga Prasad, who shaped me in every way, this thing. He said, okay, I can understand your desire, but you must marry and take care of your father. I was surprised. I thought he will encourage me otherwise. He said, it's our duty in our Hindu tradition to take care of the parents, particularly when they are ill. Mother is not there, so it is your duty. I was not satisfied first time. Otherwise, whatever he used to say, I used to follow, and I used to have such an influence on me. So then I went to Pranta Pracharak, Vijayawada. I used to be one Somaya. Sompali Somaya is no more now. Very affectionate, very lovable person. So I asked him. He said, no, you have to marry and take care of the family. I said, Somayaji, you have disappointed me. I thought you will give me good advice. He said, no, this is our tradition, you must go and marry. But he said, you marry in such a family where your in-laws will agree to take care of your father and then allow you to go and study. Then I went and told my relatives. They were all surprised, pleasantly surprised, because they were not expecting this to happen. So then I married one of my relatives' daughter, who is my wife now. So that shows how Sangha thinks about individual. Otherwise, normally they would have said, okay, you study and then you become a Pracharak, anyhow you have no other responsibility. They did not. So this is my experience with the Sangha. Then I did I had to do law. There is no law in my university. So going to Nagpur and all, my wife told me, at least do a favor, you study law somewhere nearer so that you can come vacation. Nowadays Nagpur or Delhi is not that much far away because of the connectivity. Those days, going to Nagpur means 2 days by train. And so I joined law at Vishakhapatnam, studied law, and then after marriage. Then there, became a little popular student leader, became president of the university. First time in South India, the ABVP has won the university union election, and I was the candidate. It was a greater exposure. Then there was the Gujarat Navanirmana Samiti movement, and also the total revolution call given by J. Prakash Narayan in Patna University. There were incidents, protest against corruption. Then fascinated by that, and also the ABVP background, I invited George Fernandez once, Rajamath Sindhya once, and then J. Prakash Narayan once to the university to address the students. So subsequently, of course, students were very happy. JP also was very much impressed by me. And then he made me as the convener of the Chhatra Yuva Sangharsh Samiti of Andhra Pradesh to go around and mobilize the states, students with the ABVP background, and I could easily reach out to the student community and mobilize students also in a big way from a southern state. There, of course, that was, the university has given me much more enlightenment. There, my professors, some of the professors used to be RSS. The Prant Sangacharak, Dr. Subramanya Sastri, used to be a professor in Telugu. All these things had a greater impact where I learned discipline, hard work, dedication, commitment to a cause. These are the foundations that the RSS, the ABVP has laid down in me. That's why I could reach. You'll all be surprised the way I grew up. Sometimes I am also surprised. I am son of a illiterate family, no political background, because you know in dynasty, in democracy is nasty, but tasty to many people in this country. Because of hard work and dedication, commitment, step, school people leader, college vice president, college president, university student and chairman, then state secretary ABVP, then national secretary ABVP, state president of the Yuva Morcha, national vice president of the Yuva Morcha, then MLA at a very young age, then leader of the party in assembly, though I was young, there were other seniors, but still I was made leader. Then state general secretary BJP, then state president BJP 2 terms, then national general secretary, then national spokesperson of the BJP, then national president, then rural development minister, then urban development minister, parliament affairs minister, and then INB minister. All these things, they came to me without asking. And moreover, you know, in BJP, there is no question of Pairavi or doing any Ganesh Parikrama se kuch hota nahi. You have to do Janata Janardhan ka Parikrama. So with all this, and moreover, I can tell you, in the present day, in politics, you see that you need some leader or guardian like that. Ideology was my guardian, simple. I never touched anybody's feet so far, including Atal Bihari Vajpayee Advaniji. Advaniji is really my mentor at every level. He used to guide me. And I used to admire Vajpayee ji next to God, because I have not seen God. I used to think, because admiration for his ability, for his stability, for his caliber, all. But still never touched his feet also. And I tell in my party, in the party also, Arya, don't touch the feet. But still, I came up to this level. No looking back. 2 times MLA, 4 times MP, 2 times minister, and important portfolios. All. They offered me much more important portfolio, first time. I was party general secretary. There was a discussion in the party, and government came first time, saying tomorrow onwards, ministry, Vajpayee ji, Prime Minister, Advaniji will be there. Then some of the seniors were all going to Sushma, Pramod, Jetri little later, and others. Then who is going to be in the party office? The casual discussion. I warranted myself, I will be in the party office. Advaniji later told me, why? We are only discussing, but you have offered yourself that you don't want to become a minister. I said, minister, the other secretary of the party is important. So like that. But later, and Kumara Mangalam was a minister from South. He died suddenly. So then there was death of a senior leader from South in the government. So Vajpayee ji told me, called me on phone and said, Venkaiah, unko sarkar mein aana hai. मैंने कहा तुरंत सर वही मंत्री बनना है. मैंने कहा अटल जी मुझे आप डी प्रमोट करना चाहते हैं. तो उन्होंने कहा डी प्रमोशन क्या है. मैंने कहा सर अभी तक मैं महामंत्री हूँ भाजपा का, कल से मैं मंत्री बनूंगा तो डी प्रमोशन होगा. ही वॉज लॉफिंग लाइक एनीथिंग. दिस आर ऑल द वेज ही यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब थिंग्स एंड देन वी हैव लर्न्ड समथिंग फ्रॉम हिम. सो देन दे वांटेड मी टू बिकम पावर मिनिस्टर बिकॉज रंगा वॉज पावर मिनिस्टर surface transport. I said, sir, I have a desire. Then he asked me, what is it? I said, Krishi Kshetra, Krishi Dije Mujhe, agriculture. He inquired and said, agriculture cannot be given to you because it is with Nitish Kumar, who is our ally at that time. He's ally, government ally. So, no agriculture. Then I said, sir, Mujhe, Gramin Vikas. Gramin Vikas, ekdam hasne lage Ataji. Gramin Vikas? Gramin Vikas. You know what is Gramin Vikas? I said, sir, yes, sir, my gaon se hum. So then he called us, his secretary, Brajesh Mishra, and told him that we made as a grant, rural development. Then later he told Advaniji, "Bhai, people are always after economic portfolios, and this man is saying, I want agriculture or I want rural development and all. So that rural development, this Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sadak Yojana, all this Gramin Avas Yojana. All these things have given a new profile to me and to the government also. That's how, because importance of organization. When you go around the country, meet the people, greet with the people, I can tell you, I have very at young age as ABVP activist, I have seen some of the country, as BJP activist of the state president, I went around all the seats, all districts number of times, no other work. And then, as BJP National General Secretary 7 years, in charge of headquarters, then BJP president 2 terms, went around the country, except the northeastern states, which I have covered, of course, each state 2-3 times. Every district of the country I have covered. That's why, with all confidence, I am able to speak on issues. And moreover, another interesting thing, I never learned Hindi. Mera gaon Chennai ka bagal mein hai. So Chennai mein us samay Hindi virodh andolan chal rahe the. So humne bhi Hindi virodh andolan mein bhag liya. Those days, strike means enjoyment, happy, holiday, every day. So we came out of school, college, and then started saying Hindi down, down. So हम लोगों को अनुमान आया भाई हिंदी कहाँ है हमारा गांव में शहर में देन एवरी वन स्टार्ट टॉकिंग टू अदर फैन भाई हिंदी कहाँ है विरोध करना है तो यू नीड समथिंग ना ऑब्जेक्टिव और ए पर्सनल दिस थिंग सो एक लड़का के बताया 2 जगह पे है हिंदी कहाँ एक लड़का पोस्ट ऑफिस में डाकघर लिखा है वहाँ दूसरा रेलवे स्टेशन So we got into 2 batches and 1 batch went to railway station, another batch went to police post office. And then put tar on the dabba. Later, when I came to Delhi in 1993, as BJP RLA General Secretary, उस समय मुझे समझ में आया, मैंने वो डाक घर के डब्बे के ऊपर नहीं मेरा चेहरा के ऊपर तार लगाया बिकॉज हिंदी के बिना हिंदुस्तान में आगे बढ़ना संभव नहीं बिकॉज दैट्स अ लैंग्वेज नोन टू many people in the country. And a public reader must be always familiar with as many languages as possible, particularly with the language spoken by a large number of people. So my advice to all the youngsters is always first master your mother tongue and then focus on national language and then learn English also. English also is useful. We should not be anti-English, but we should be anti-English mindset. Because the colonial rule has really our swabhiman, our swasakti, this ke upar bahut asar dala. So recently I have been to Latin America, Guatemala, Peru, Panama. In those 3 countries, nobody knows their mother tongue. Everybody was speaking in Spanish language because of colonial rule. There are some French colonies in the country. They are also same. Charan Singh ji came, we were translating, suddenly the power gone. I started translating. There were nearly 15,000-20,000 people. My voice was so strong and so powerful. Those days. And then shuru-shuru mein humare paas wo mic ka vyavastha bhi nahi tha. Ek aluminium dabbe, mic type bana ke aisa usi se announce karte the. Usi se announce karte the. So those days. That has really made me strong and then brought me to this level. Of course, and also see, going around, touring and all, it gives you more knowledge, more understanding. First, you must study. Study not books, study people, their life, their lifestyle. And during tours also, you must make night halt in the rural areas. That gave me more knowledge. That made me acceptable. Otherwise, a South Indian fellow, without much political background or knowledge or without Hindi, becoming acceptable to North India, going around. मैं फुटी फुटी हिंदी बोलते थे उस समय यहाँ के दीदी मैं पत्रकारों से बात करते करते धीरे धीरे हिंदी सीखा शुरू में मैं इन स्पाइट ऑफ माई कनेक्शन विद संगा एंड ए बी वी पी आई नेवर टुक हिंदी सीरियसली दोज डेज ऑल्सो ठीक है, हमारा लैंग्वेज है ऐसा. बट देन आई केम हियर टू द ऑल इंडिया सीन, देन आई रियलाइज इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ हिंदी. देन इट वॉज टू लेट बाय द टाइम टू लर्न इन लैंग्वेज, एंड उतना टाइम भी नहीं है. बिकॉज माई हैबिट इज, आई मस्ट टेल यू नाउ, ऑफ कोर्स देर इज रीजन फॉर मी, सम रीजन इज देयर. आई कॉन्ट स्लीप विदाउट वर्क, एंड रेस्ट मीन्स दैट्स द मोस्ट टायर समथिंग इन माई लाइफ. And I used to say, rest only when you are under arrest. Otherwise, no rest. What is rest? Sometime you have to sleep. Jitna jaye utna bas. Baki time, bhogam karna. Used to go around, even as party president also, my children used to bring crows to the railway station, from one station to another station. They used to bring crows to the helicopter, this thing, from here to other. My daughter, thoda mazak mein kehte, thoda satire, maybe, satirical or sarcastic. हमारे पिताजी कभी कभी हमारा घर भी आते हैं. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आई यूज टू स्पेंड टाइम, एंड आई यूज टू आउट ईट इन डिफरेंट हाउसेस. संगा सिस्टम इज यू दे विल नॉट मेक यू टू रेस्ट इन लॉज या होटल और ए गेस्ट हाउस. दैट हैज मेड यू टू अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट फैमिली लाइफ, पीपल, देयर मेंटालिटी, ऑल दीज थिंग्स. सो दीज आर ऑल थिंग्स दैट हैव रियली चेंज्ड मी. लाइफ Before I conclude, I want to tell you all, everyone must have some aim. Ambition next, first aim. And then you must also dream. Kuch na kuch banna chahiye. And then aim and dream alone will not take you to that position. You must work hard. And you must forget some of your other comforts. You can't have both. Even I used to have a desire by evening, come back home and spend some time with my daughter, son, little play with children and all. No chance at all. By the time I used to come home, children used to sleep. By the time they used to wake up, I used to go away. So literally there was no time to spend. You are missing. My wife also, poor lady. Most of the time, I'm outside. But still, she's happy that I have become something in life. Because there is a saying in Telugu, you can't have both Ava and Bua. Ava means grandmother, that I want to spend time with my grandmother. Bua means food. It's a rural saying. If you want to have Bua, you must work hard. That's the message. So if you want your husband to become an MLA, minister, or a scientist, or a professor, or a doctor, or an actor, he must leave some personal life and then focus more on that. That's why you see, you know, actors, doctors, or politicians, scientists, they don't spend much time with family members. But here, the beauty is because of Sangha. Every family is our family. That gives you satisfaction. Otherwise, every day going around meeting different families, spending time with them. All this, that used to give. And another thing I have learned, you must enjoy what you are doing. Then only you will be able to do it. Otherwise, it will be sometimes boring, tiring. Initially, that BJP never used to win election in my area, Janasangh. So there is another interesting thing. My uncle took me to a senior politician who is close to our family, congressman, elderly man. So, and he told him, our boy want to join some party. Those days party name also Janasangh, not known. I have not joined Janasangh also, but I used to develop interest for Vajpayee's and then Janasangh because of this ABP background. So then he asked me, what party? I said, I am not joining party, but I am inclined towards Janasangh. He started laughing, Janasangh? I said, yes. अरे ये तो उत्तर भारतीय पार्टी है. आई हर्ड. सेकंड ही सेड वो तो शहरी इलाके का पार्टी है. देन आई कैप्ट क्वाइट. देन उन्होंने कहा ये पढ़ी लिखी लोगों का पार्टी है. देन उन्होंने कहा ये तो ब्राह्मण बनिया पार्टी है. अंत में उन्होंने कहा तो ये शाकाहारी पार्टी है. ये पहले तीन चार बोला ना, मुझे ज़्यादा इसमें ये नहीं आया. जब चौथा बोला तो मेरा मन में डाउट आया, तो ये क्या है, सच है क्या. तो बाद में मैं मेरा प्रचारक से पूछा, उन्होंने कहा ऐसा कोई नियम नहीं है, खूब गा सकते हैं, मगर हम जो भी चाहे वो गा सकते हैं, मगर हमारा ओटीसी में कैंप में हम नॉन वेजिटेरियन इसलिए सर्व नहीं करते बिकॉज कैंप में आते हम सीखने के लिए, खाने के लिए नहीं, प्रायोरिटी इज जस्ट फूड इज नेसेसिटी दैट्स ऑल यू आर ईटिंग। वहाँ दो व्यवस्था, एक वेजिटेरियन सेपरेट एक नॉन वेजिटेरियन सेपरेट, ये सब क्यों करना, सिंपल है, द ट्रेनिंग इज यू मस्ट एडजस्ट टू द सिचुएशन एंड देन यू मस्ट हैव कॉमन दिस, अरे उतना ही, अदरवाइज यू कैन ईट एंड यू कैन इन्वाइट एनीबडी, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई बिकेम समथिंग, देन आई यूज टू इन्वाइट ऑल प्रचारक सर, पीपल यूज टू से यू आर स्पॉइलिंग ऑल प्रचारक सर, नॉन पक्का नॉन वेजिटेरियन बिकॉज आई वाज स्ट्रिक्ट नॉन वेजिटेरियन दोज डेज, बिकॉज नाउ I have reduced because doctor has told me that you have eaten enough for this life. Take care of your take care of your health. More non-vegetarian means you eat more rice because of South Indian habit. Then high weight also, then other things, then diabetic, etc. So that, these are all the falsehoods spread about Sangha. Yeah, all these things. This is how the impression was. The same gentleman, and I became MLA and I became something, he is, everybody used to go to his house those days, all parties even, because finally one day he came to my house and said, you became such a great person, ordinary person and all, because I even never imagined, I never thought that I'll become something and this party is going to come to power, but hard work, discipline, enjoying the work, what you are doing, and then the basic philosophy of India, sharing and caring, India, and even about this Hindu also. There is also a wrong notion among the people, Hindu means religion and all. Hindu is a way of life, it's not religion. And we talk of Hindu or Hindutva, it should not be seen in a narrow religious concept. It's a broader cultural identity of this nation. I explain in normal terms in my own way. Sometime back I spoke in Parliament also, because with vengeance I was waiting for an opportunity to tell the country what is Hindutva. These all people are damning Hindu, insulting Hindu. So one day I got the opportunity in Parliament and I became a Parliament Affairs Minister. They were criticizing Hindu. Then I took on them and explained what is Hindu. Ye naam Sriman Atal Bihari Vajpayee ne diya nahi, ne to RSS ne diya nahi. Maine kaha Hindu akhbar hai. क्या हिंदुओं के लिए है क्या? साइलेंस इन द हाउस. हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स हिंदुओं के लिए है क्या? हिंदुस्तान अखबार हिंदुओं के लिए है क्या? देन आई सेड हिंदुस्तान एयरनॉट्स लिमिटेड, हिंदुस्तान शिपयार्ड लिमिटेड, हिंदुस्तान मशीन टूल्स लिमिटेड, योर वॉच, हिंदुस्तान केबल्स लिमिटेड, लाइक दैट आई गेव सम 50 नेम्स ऑल. एंड देन यू गो टू पाकिस्तान, देर से कहाँ से आ रहे हैं आप? हिंदुस्तान से? नहीं नहीं, मैं हिंदुस्तान से नहीं आ रहा हूँ, कब्रस्तान से आ रहा हूँ, ऐसा कहेंगे. हिंदुस्तान से ये नाम है तो दिस जगह का नाम है. इट्स ए जियोग्राफिकल आइडेंटिटी एंड कल्चरल आइडेंटिटी. वर्ड हिंदू, सिंधु, सिंधु, हिंदू. सो बट वाई शुड एनीबडी हैव एवर्शन टू दिस? एंड वी टॉक ऑफ हिंदू, अकॉर्डिंग टू माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग, हिंदू मीन्स द कल्चरल आइडेंटिटी ऑफ दिस नेशन, हाउ वी लिव्ड, द ट्रेडिशंस, द हेरिटेज, द फैमिली सिस्टम, द वैल्यू सिस्टम, respect for the elders, respect for the parents, respect for the guru, respect for the animals, pasu pakshi ko bhi manyata dete hindutva. You see people feeding birds, people giving chakkar dete, ant hota hai na, ant ko kya kehte hai, cheat, usko bhi kuch log chakkar dete. Aur nagal chauthi, nag panchmi mein जाके दूध डालते हो, जहाँ सर ये है ना, स्नेक है, स्नेक बैठ आपको, बट स्टिल दैट इज द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ दिस कंट्री. आई टेल यू अनदर पर्सनल इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, यू आर यंगस्टर. सो आई यूज टू गो होम ड्यूरिंग हॉलीडेज. सो माय ग्रैंडफादर यूज टू से, यू आर ए सन ऑफ ए फार्मर, लैंड फार्मिंग, डोंट रिलैक्स. सो हॉलीडेज यूज टू गो रिमूव द कौ डंग इन द हाउस. यू से व्हाट इज दिस मैन इज आस्किंग यू टू डू ऑल दिस एंड ऑल. ही सेड यू मस्ट लैंड ऑल दिस. Then plowing the field, then supporting the plantation, etc. So then during one season, there used to be bajra and jowar and other crops. So those, when they become ripe, the birds used to come and then eat them. So we used to have a platform, a high-rise platform, and then we used to get up into the platform, and then used to have a stone in a jute this thing, and then used to do like this, and then make some sound and throw it to drive away the birds. Okay. Then after the harvesting, when the crop used to come, we used to cut the crop like this. It's not like rice. So my grandfather used to, in front of the house, in the veranda, he used to hang some of the rice portions, jowar and bajra, there to the veranda. I asked him, what for this? He said, oh, pakshiyon ke liye. Pakshi aake usko wahan khade hokar khaake jaate the. Then I told my grandfather, you told me you go and drive away the pakshis. Then he told me, Babu, at that time the crop was not ripe. The pakshi do not know, it has no that much knowledge. So it spoils this one. But now it's ripe and you got your crop. You are going to eat. Share it with others, with the birds also. Give something to that. That's the tradition. That's the culture. That's the Hindutva. But unfortunately, some people give it a narrow interpretation. Not only, I must tell you frankly, not only opponents, so-called supporters also, some people, they give it a very narrow interpretation and all. The way of living, culture is a way of living. Religion is a way of worship. Religion is something different, the way you pray. But culture is the way you live. So we youngsters and whoever believes in the philosophy of RSS, we should focus more on our culture, less on religion. I'm not saying don't be religious and all. No puja, religious, whatever religion you want to follow, follow. But at the end of it, the national interest lies in preserving your culture, your heritage. The yoga, now worldwide there is interaction. Your Swamiji is going around. Worldwide, there is attraction towards. People want peace. People want progress. So we in India have shown earlier, India was known as Viswa Guru, Naranda and Takshasala, those days. Students come from abroad and they used to study. Huan Song and Pahian, the Chinese historians, they wrote about our history. Unfortunately, because of Britishers, our history is distorted. Our original history, the sacrifice made, the way we lived, all those things have been removed from the textbooks. And you talk anything like that about bringing back the national pride, they say saffronization, they say as if this thing, Hinduization, ghettoization and all. By narrowly interpreting Hindutva. So we have to be careful in our attitude, in our life. You have Jain, you have Vaishnava, you have Saiva, you have this, and you have a Christian, you have a Muslim, what is wrong? The religion is way of worship, but everyone must love the country. Last concluding, country means what? There is another point I want to tell, particularly all youngsters. We shout, Bharat Mata ki Jai. Agreed. What is Bharat Mata? Bharat Mata is a simply photograph with that flag and with all this frizzle or whatever it is. Or is it only a geographical boundary? Bharat Mata means all 130 crore people of the country, their welfare, their upliftment, unka uthan. Jab tak aap uske upar focus nahi karenge, Bharat Mata jay ko koi ard nahi hai. You can't hate your neighbor simply because he belongs to some other this thing. And then somebody as lower caste, somebody higher caste, it is not there in Shastras, it is not there in Vedas, it came in between. And then treating women as second, this thing, as if they are not equals. They have done wonders, they are doing wonders and they are given opportunities. This is the basic philosophy of Hindutva. Gargayi, Maitreyi, they used to come and used to give judgments or pravachans those days. Susruta, the first surgeon of India, Susruta. And you have Charaka, you have Aryabhatta, you have Bhaskar, so many great examples of knowledge and wisdom that was given by our forefathers. All that is called, all that civilization is called as broadly Hindu culture. So some people, now there people are trying to confuse it because of politics came, na, in between politics. And then minority, majority, who is minority, who is majority? All are Indians. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. One nation, one people, one country. That also is being wrongly interpreted. One people means all other people are thrown out. Who told you? You, for your own vote bank politics, you are creating that sort of psychology. People. So we have to be clear in our mind, clear in our approach. This culture has given land to Christians who came to set up churches, the Maharajas, the Muslims and all. You have examples of Sant Kabir, you have example of Sant Tukaram, you have examples of Basaveswara, you have examples of Narayan Guru, you have examples of so many other great people in this country. And even the social changes that has come, even against that also, Rajaram Mohan Rai, or Kandukur Virasingham Pantulu, or Narayan Guru, they have not come from outside to reform our society. They have come from within. Ek Mahatma Gandhi, ek Ambedkar, ek Ambedkar. Who is Ambedkar again? He is also from this society. Who fought against the social inequalities, etc. So this outlook, if you develop, will have a bright future, and then India also will become